Hello student, good morning. This is Shushankar Dale, assistant professor from Government College Engineering, Bikaner, from Mechanical Department. In last lecture we have learned that the Carnot cycle. Now we will learn the vapor compression refrigeration cycles. Okay, in last lecture also we have seen the what is vapor compression refrigeration cycle and why the vapor compression refrigeration cycle is required. The vapor compression refrigeration cycle is derived from the Carnot cycle by doing some modification. What are the modifications are done in Carnot cycle for deriving the VCR cycle? First modification is the isothermal heat rejection process is replaced by the isobaric heat rejection process. We have seen that in last lecture the Carnot cycle as the condenser is heat is released at the isothermal process. Now that isothermal process is replaced by the isobaric, that is the constant pressure process. Here the temperature is changing, okay, for rejection of the heat. Second modification is the in Carnot cycle the expansion is done with the help of the turbine. Here the isentropic expansion of liquid is replaced by the isenthalpic throttling. Here the expansion is takes place at constant enthalpy. In Carnot cycle what happened? The expansion is done with the help of turbine at constant entropy. But here we are doing the expansion at constant enthalpy with the help of the throttling device. This cycle is also known as the reverse Rankine cycle. Now, how this cycle works and how it looks or how to represent on the TS diagram, that we'll see here. The standard, there are some types of the VCR cycle, but here we see the standard saturated single stage VCR cycle. Okay. Now, the exit condition of evaporator and the condenser are saturated. See, we have seen in the Carnot cycle or the reverse Carnot cycle the exit condition of evaporator is not a saturated, it is a wet condition, it is a mixture of the vapor and the liquid. We have seen that because that mixture, that is the drawback of the Carnot cycle. You have to overcome that drawback because we have seen in the Carnot cycle the mixture of vapor and the liquid goes into the compressor, that is cause the some causes takes place of the compressor, that you have to avoid that drawback. Okay, exit condition of evaporator and condenser are saturated. Here the cycle consists of one side is low side pressure and another side is high side pressure. If you see this diagram, that in this are is you use the devices evaporator, compressor, condenser and expansion device. In Carnot cycle here we use the turbine. Now we replace turbine by the expansion device. That is process 1 to 2 is the evaporator, 2 to 3 is the compressor, 3 to 4 is condenser and 4 to 1 is the expansion device. Now the path or the process 1 to 2 is the isobaric and isothermal heat addition. Here in evaporator at constant pressure as well as the constant temperature we are adding the heat. Extraction of heat takes place in the evaporator 1 to 2 process. 2 to 3 is the isentropic compression, that is at constant entropy the compression is takes place. 3 to 4, here the 3 to 4 process is the isobaric, here not a isothermal heat rejection process, because if you see this TS diagram from 3 to 3 dash the temperature is decreasing, but from the 3 dash to 4 the temperature is constant, but the process actually takes place from 3 to 4. Okay, means the temperature is changing, okay, but pressure is constant. That's why here the main difference of the Carnot cycle and the VCR cycle is here the isobaric heat rejection takes place in the VCR cycle. Now 4 to 1 is the isenthalpic expansion. with the help of the throttling device, here the expansion is takes place from process 4 to 1. That is not isentropic, the enthalpy is not constant, but the here the sorry entropy is not constant but here the enthalpy is constant, 4 to 1. The 4 to 1 process is indicated by the dotted line. Why this 4 to 1 process is indicated by dotted line? Because this process is very highly reversible process. You know that in reversible process is indicated by the dotted line. And why the we are reversible process indicated by dotted line? Because we know exactly the node, we don't know the path, we know the only the endpoints. Okay, that's why it is indicated by the dotted line. Okay, now we see the comparison between Carnot and the standard VCR cycle. First comparison is the refrigeration effect of VCR cycle decreases. How the refrigeration of VCR cycle decreases compared to the Carnot cycle? We see with the help of this TS diagram. Okay, the actual VCR cycle, we know that 1, 2, 3, 4. But here we indicate the one Carnot cycle, that is 1 dash, 2, 3 double dash and 4, that is the Carnot cycle. We know that refrigeration effect is nothing but heat extraction in the evaporator. Okay, that is QE Carnot. It is integration of TDS. Okay, for Carnot, we know that in also we have seen in the last lecture, area is A1-2C. And if you see the QC for VCR cycle, because VCR cycle here, the area under the VCR cycle for QC, that is heat extraction, B12C. If you take the difference of these, you will get the that much area of A2 here. Indicated in this diagram, area A2 is less amount of heat is extracted in the VCR cycle. That's why this is also called a throttling loss. In VCR cycle, the refrigeration effect is less compared to the Carnot cycle. Next point, heat rejection increases. Okay, heat rejection increases, same thing is indicated in the TS diagram, that is the area above that area A1 is extra area that indicate the extra amount of heat is release. Okay, if you see from this equation, the QC Carnot, that is heat rejected in the condenser, the area A43CC. If you see the QC for VCR, area A43C, means if you take the difference of heat rejected for VCR and Carnot cycle, you will get the area A1, means extra amount of heat is released in the Carnot cycle compared to the Carnot cycle. The compressor work input increases. We know that the net work done is nothing but the heat extraction minus the difference of the heat. Okay, now we know that the refrigeration effect is reduces and heat rejection increases. Means what happened with the net work done also increases. Okay, net work done is increases, that's why compressor input work input increases. Okay, we know that the COP of any cycle is nothing but the ratio of the refrigeration effect upon the net work done. Here in VCR cycle, refrigeration effect decreases, net work done increases, means the COP of VCR cycle is decreases, or you can say that less compared to the Carnot cycle. That's why here I have written that COP of VCR cycle is less than the COP of the Carnot cycle. Next point, that is cycle efficiency. Now here for cycle efficiency, here we define the cycle efficiency. It is the ratio of the COP of that VCR cycle to the COP of Carnot cycle. It is always less than 1 because we know that the COP of Carnot cycle is maximum compared to other any cycle. Okay, now one line is here written, the cycle efficiency depends very much on the shape of the TS diagram, which is turn depends on the nature of the working fluid. We have seen that the COP of Carnot cycle is only depend upon the temperatures, that is the source and sink temperature, or you can say the temperature of the evaporator and the condenser. But the COP of the Carnot cycle is not depend upon the nature of the working fluid, but the COP or the cycle efficiency of the VCR cycle is depends upon the working fluid or the refrigerant used in that refrigerator. Okay, how that is depend, that we'll see in the next lecture. Okay, thank you students.